Welcome to Democracy Now!, democracynow.org, The War and Peace Report. I'm Amy Goodman. In Yemen, a civilian is dying nearly every hour from a massive cholera outbreak as the ongoing U.S.-backed, Saudi-led bombing campaign and naval blockade has devastated Yemen's health, sanitation and water systems. The World Health Organization says cholera has now killed at least 859 people. More than 100,000 are infected. This is the health ministry spokesperson, Abdelhakim Al-Khalani.
The ministry had to announce the state of emergency. The ministry announced that it is powerless in facing this epidemic on its own and that we need international support and international organizations to aid in combating this epidemic.
Last month, President Donald Trump signed a series of arms deals with Saudi Arabia, totaling a record $110 billion during his visit to Riyadh. United Nations monitors have warned Saudi-led airstrikes in Yemen could constitute crimes against humanity. Over 10,000 people have died since the U.S.-backed, Saudi-led bombing campaign began in 2015. We'll go to Yemen for more on the cholera epidemic after headlines. In Syria, U.S.-backed troops fighting ISIS and Raqqa have been accused of deploying munitions loaded with white phosphorus, an incendiary weapon whose use in populated civilian areas banned under international law. Photos and video published by the local journalist group Raqqa is being slaughtered silently, show what appears to be white phosphorus filling the air over Raqqa on Thursday night amidst the U.S.-backed offensive to retake the city from ISIS. White phosphorus munitions can burn human flesh down to the bone, and wounds contaminated by the chemical can reignite up to days later, poisoning victims and leading to organ failure or death. An unnamed U.S. official told the New York Times the U.S.-backed forces fighting in Raqqa have access to white phosphorus munitions. The apparent use of white phosphorus came the same night as a U.S.-backed coalition airstrike reportedly hit an internet cafe in Raqqa, killing as many as 14 civilians. The Syrian Observatory for Human Rights says one of the civilians killed was an activist who was in the middle of sending a report to the monitoring group when the airstrike destroyed the Ahasan Internet cafe. In Afghanistan, U.S. troops have been accused of killing a civilian and his two children outside his home this morning in Nangarhar province. A local Afghan official says the U.S. troops opened fire, killing the three civilians after the soldier's car was hit by a roadside bomb. Meanwhile, three U.S. soldiers were killed on Saturday, also in Nangarhar province, when an Afghan army commando turned on the U.S. troops. The U.S. and Afghan army were in the middle of a joint military operation in Achin district when the killings took place. Six U.S. soldiers have died in Afghanistan so far this year.